Michigan parents charged in son's murder. This is horrific. This is violent. This is extreme. This is heartbreaking. An 8-year-old St. Joseph's child has now died because of caregiver neglect. It has been ruled a homicide. Put up their pictures for mass. Such a damn shame. So sad. An 8-year-old child. The parents of the child, Brian and Mia Morrow, have been charged for murder of their own son. His mother told police her severely autistic son was having breathing problems and would not eat or drink, but never took him to the hospital. Okay? The parents instead waited until the next day to tell anyone about their son's death. It was the grandmother who ended up calling 911. When police arrived at the house in the 1700 block of Columbia Avenue, they found the 8-year-old dead on the couch. Records show the child weighed only 31 pounds at the time of his death. During the police questioning, the mother says, she says she was investigated by CPS several times for what she describes as unfounded reasons, okay? The parents stopped taking their son to the Logan Autism Learning Center because she was, and I quote, sick of them calling CPS on them, Child Protection Services. Court records show employees at the Logan Center were concerned with how many times the boy threw up in a day. Let me pause right here. Not only is this a parenting failure because these parents are obviously poor excuses for parents, there's a systemic failure. Now, the people at the center, they called Child Protection Services multiple times. They said, there's a problem, we need you to investigate the problem. But the problem never got fully investigated. There's more. Brian's daughter, who used to live with the Morrows, told police the 8-year-old was usually kept in his bedroom. She says Brian and Mia did not want to deal with their son because he smelled like urine and described him as so skinny, you could put your finger around his arms. Brian's daughter says the 8-year-old broke the bottom of the bedroom door so he could stick his hand out. She believed the Morrows were using meth. Mia and Brian Morrow are also charged with possessing meth and other substances. They tested positive for meth the day after their son's death. Put up the pictures again. Those two people who were designed by nature to love their 8-year-old became his worst enemy on this planet. They killed him. Okay? Now, they are going to be held accountable through the system known as justice. The 8-year-old has no due process. He is dead. But there's another failure here that must be highlighted. You mean to tell me that the Logan Autism Learning Center, they called CPS multiple times and this child was not removed? I'm an advocate for foster children because I used to be one. I've seen some extreme stories and extreme neglect. Agencies have to be held accountable when things like this are brought to their attention and nothing is done because lives are in the balance. This 8-year-old never experienced life. Adrienne, thoughts on this?
You know, I often think that there are some people out there who shouldn't have children. And without a doubt, this couple was one of them. You know, the reality is that this autism center had reached out several times to the agency. It did what it could do and what it was supposed to do. And we'd like more outside parties to do that when they see neglect, when they see a child being abused, especially a child who comes from a vulnerable population. And they did their due diligence, but then the system failed this child because they were in an unsafe place. Also, when you can see the neglect physically there, That's something that it can't be denied, and yet still the system failed this child. And I definitely do hope that the system doesn't fail in prosecuting these individuals to the fullest extent of the law. But at the same time, as you noted, the system needs to change. People need to be held accountable for not looking into this, not removing the child from that environment.
That's right, very well said. We're gonna follow this story because naturally there's an investigation now to see why this was not properly investigated. So now they have an investigation into the non-investigation.